mythical in records, like a ghost. Vigical warrior of the Drong, west of the Sydney coast. Lemmy shin his left eye, a left foot deformity. It was said by his people, this made him a clever man who could see. Pemulwuy lived peacefully with the English for over a year, till there was a murder of a Drong by a bullet, not a spear. Pemulwuy tracked down a gamekeeper, McIntyre of the colony, and as with Drong law, spear is common law should be. Branded murderer by men who could not understand. He headed for the hills, an outlaw in his own land. He knew his country intimately, and a fire began to flame. This injustice may never be destroyed, but man of the earth was his name. Hey. Oh, Bossanova, hey. He led his people in rage against any who came to claim. A mercenary outlaw setting fire to the British name. He fought them with bushfire as the settlers held their breaths. No, they didn't see it coming, as many burns to their death. British, he became the ultimate enemy. He was shot many a time, but he still managed to flee. A cold sense came over that as long as he survived, the colony was in danger. So it was that he had to die. Word passed around all along the Hawkesbury, from Campbelltown to Parramatta, that even convicts would be set free if they brought in some game. With a black, with one good eye, it seemed that they'd become guided by the line. Hey! Conflict resumed. Pemulwuy branded a beast, a murderous primate, protecting his family. Drong began to believe he could not be killed by foreign lead, and until June 1802. Pamela Warrior was shot dead. Warrior of the drum, protester for 12 years, captured twice, escaped once, as both sides faced great fears. But we still call him an outlaw, as the settlers once did. A martyr, a hero, or a father, who just done what he had.